very important that there is something which is outside, there is something private, there is something public, which is different and which has to be understood and managed very well.
That's right. Just so like when you go into a temple, you respect the area where you're going, and that's how you address.
Yeah, because there is a behavioral norm.
Yes.
So you have to do that. So that is very, very important.
I think it's same for men also. You won't have boys wearing sumbiyas and, you know, roaming about. They won't be wearing a very short dress when they are going
to
college.
That's right. That's right.
So it's for everyone. I mean, they'll be looked upon. What's happening? You know, why the guy is wearing his
beach wear to college.
In fact, for that matter, if suppose a girl is dressed very provocatively, we also look at her. It's not that men only look at her. Sometimes we also look at her.
But sometimes, okay, all this is very well said. But Poonam, I'm sure you'll agree that there are places sometimes we find that there is no exposure of the girl, or whatever clothes she's wearing is not important. But these things are still happening.
Yeah, in fact, I want to, you know, they both have kept their point of view. But
yes.
I want to tell this thing. Exactly, many times even a small girl of 5-6 years old is raped.
Yes.
What dress she's wearing, what she's
exposing. What is she doing and exposing? Yes, correct.
So you can't blame the girl for everything. Like the situation. But I agree ke the girls should be properly dressed, like regarding whatever, wherever they are going. If it's a swimming pool, they can wear a swimsuit and have a swim there. But while going to some places, they should be more appropriately dressed. But that is not the only reason for rape. Rape could happen anywhere. And that is exactly the mindset of the man. You can't blame that on the ladies.
I'm sure when you analyze these kind of situations, these cases, because she's right, when we these days look at some figures and the kind of crimes that are reported, and they are against these little minors. So when you do your researches, your analysis, what do you really find? Why are these things on such a high?
I totally agree with Poonam, because when we analyze, it's the dress does not matter. I'm not talking about rape.
Correct.
I'm talking about every day
eve teasing,
sexual harassment, and molestation, which takes place on the streets when a woman is traveling for her workplace, for her education, on the road. Even then, dressing appropriately is not a guarantee that you will not be harassed.
Oh yes.
It is, as I said, it is, how do I avoid being a victim? How do I be smartly dressed so that I can defend myself if need be? I can seek help. So that's there. And if we analyze the rape cases, 96 to 97% of the cases are within the confines of the home or the near relatives or friends.
Friendly entries always,
So it's only the 4% where you have such cases where an unknown person or, you know, stuff like that has happened.
Let's also talk a little bit on the other side. You know, we are seeing these crimes being on the rise and everything, and rape victims getting younger and younger and all that. So do you think the media somewhere needs to get its act together? Especially when I say media, I don't just mean television or the print media, but also the Indian film industry. Do you think that somewhere down the line, they need to play a much better, much more positive role than what is happening today? Because everything and anything is being glamorized.
That's true. In fact, you know, media has been playing and plays a very important role. You know, in most of the movies, they show that, you know, the girl is walking on the street and
she's
the boy
being pursued
pursued by the boy or his friends. And, you know, there is always a song. The heroine is always introduced like, you know, she's in a college. And the first entry is where the boys all come and start, you know, making fun of her. And then there is some kind of an interaction, and then things go on like that. The other thing is, you know what, everywhere it says that, you know, constantly it's repeated again and again. It's women is like nature, where, you know, the way we look at nature and appreciate, similarly we have to appreciate and look at women. So we need to control.
Appreciation is so different, you know, than desiring
something. That's true. But then, you know, appreciation has got different degrees.
Yes,
the way it is done is something which one is not able to control and one is not able to understand. So it's like, you know, so nature needs to be controlled, women needs to be controlled. So therefore what they do is women is very wild, so start controlling. The, you know, in movies also they show that if the wife is, you know, shouting or like trying to put her foot down or trying to assert herself, the husband slaps her.
Right.
Very common thing. Then if the woman is misbehaving or trying to act very smart, so-called smartness, they say the, you know, only way to stop her, rape her. Or molest her.
Correct.
So these are the kind of things which happen in media, almost like in all the movies, which are very, very popular commercial movies.
Correct.
So I think media plays a very, very positive and negative
role. As well as a negative role. That's true. And I think it's very important for people to understand that those are just stories. But well, sadly, that doesn't happen. And youngsters especially start believing everything that is shown on celluloid. Well, time for us to slip into another break. Do come back quickly as I'll see you on the other side. Welcome back. This is Gender Discourse, and today we are talking about safety of women in the cities. Well, we were talking about celluloid and how women are depicted in films. Well, I think, Suman, you'll agree with me that if you were to ask a youngster about his or her role model, the role models would all be from the film industry and nothing else. So, which means that these people have a far greater responsibility upon themselves as to how they project themselves, right?
Yes, I totally agree, and along with that, the cricketers.
Oh, yes, the cricketers. How could one forget that? Yes.
Yes, there is a dearth of positive role models in the industry. I agree with Rajshri on how male person in the movie, the hero, is projected. You know, he's the one who's teasing, and you know, it's bordering on teasing and sexual harassment, and then later on. So that's a role model which is being created. So we need a positive role model just to say that, you know, when your teasing can be hurting.
How
do you demarcate? It's when a woman says that it's hurting me, that should be enough. That's not a friendly banter. Then it borders on harassment. And that's an offense, that's a crime. So, I mean, we recognizing that, we have, you know, roped in Farhan Akhtar for our campaign. So he's the one who's, we have a 1 minute clip also, and we have put it on YouTube and we'll be releasing it shortly. So he's the one who's talking about male masculinity. What is male masculinity?
Right.
It's not harassing, it's not imposing. It's, you know, respecting a woman. It's making sure that she's safe. That's also your duty as a, if you, talk about.
I think it's very encouraging to know that, you know, that a role model like Mr. Akhtar is actually coming and doing something like this, and I'm sure the youngsters will relate very quickly, and I'm sure you must be.
That being the case, because we thought, you know, if we have a male icon, you know, so then people, the youngsters, especially they associate with it, and the recall is much more.
Much more, true.
I mean, they will remember, you know, it doesn't just, you know, go out of the way. So it. It'll be, the recall will be there, and they'll be willing to listen. It's not like a teacher teaching them and then sleeping about it. So that's where we thought we'll end.
I think you'll agree with this, Poonam, because I think it's now time that the approach has to change, and I think that's what the Delhi Police is doing.
Yeah, I feel they have done a nice job.
Yes, yes.
Making a film on Farhan Akhtar.
That's true. So you think that this can be taken as a cue by the other states, and you know, maybe the government of India can also take up issues like these, and especially these people, the ones who are role models and icons in the eyes of the youngsters, that could go a long way.
That's exactly what we have done in Gujarat. We have taken Amitabh Bachchan as our ambassador, and whenever he says ke kuch nahi dekha to kuch nahi dekha, so people come and meet me and tell me, are you member of parliament from Kutch? So it has become more famous.
That's right.
So I think it makes a lot of difference when you use people who are famous and they will project
influential. Yes. Well, so Rajalakshmi, now finally, I would want you to talk a little bit about the fact as to, we've talked about the self mechanism and all that, defense mechanism. What else do you think girls should be more aware of in order to protect themselves?
See, one of the most important things is, it's not just the girls, but all of us must understand that equal relationship should be there. If there is equal relationships, if there is equality in the society between men and women, there won't be any violence. And this is something which is very, very important for all of us to understand and recognize. And I think I did talk about the negative aspect. I also would say that there is a positive impact of the media also, because if you see recently, there are some kind of advertisements which are shown on television where they show that, you know, both men and women are doing the household works also, you know, together. Like used to be this ad, where Rin ad, where a woman used to come, you know, man used to come back from the office and say, oh God, today I was denied the promotion because my
you
shirt
did
was
not
clean.
Wash my
yeah,
shirt.
You did not yes. wash my shirt. But today you see Salman Khan, you know, this many role model for many youngsters. He along with the model is washing clothes. So these kind of positive impact is also there. Movies also are showing where the girl is coming from a different city, trying to cope up, you know, and be an independent woman. So this is also there, where it is increasing the confidence of the girls. So but I would again go back to say the same thing. It is very, very important for all us to be educated, aware of the fact that a violence-free society is a society where there is equality between
the
people.
Two sexes. That's right. Between well, I think sexes. Now it is just the right time for us to give you a little list as to what are the tips that you can take home, and if there's ever any danger of that sort, how to tackle it. So girls, especially you all, take a look at this one.
Important safety tips. Inform family members as you are about to leave office. Always carry a pepper spray in your handbag. Always keep your car in good condition. As soon as you get into your car, lock the doors and leave. If you use public transport, try moving in a group. Keep a cell phone that is completely charged. Avoid using subways at night. If someone stalks you, kick hard in the groin or poke the eyes. Scream for help whenever you sense danger. Take the stairs instead of the elevator. Dial 100 as soon as you sense danger.
Well, those are definitely some numbers that you can use, but there are also some other numbers that can be used in case if you are in any kind of danger. And Suman, I'd like you to tell the viewers today as to which are the numbers that they can dial.
1091, that's our woman helpline, which is answered by a woman, so that if you have any hesitation in speaking to a male police officer, we do have 100 also has a lot of women, but 1091 is exclusively with a woman. But if it's an immediate response that you want, then I would suggest 100 because of the number of lines that 100 has.
And of course, they can be directed then, you know, to the right person after some time, even if they dial 100.
That will be there and they will be guided. And another thing is, we have this number, we have 1091, but there is a hesitation. So I would suggest that don't hesitate. If you sense danger, do dial. Even if it's a false alarm, let it be.
That's right.
So just report it.
That's so true. And also, I would like you to tell them a little bit about how to really file an FIR, and what is it that they must, what is the kind of information that they must give as the first hand information report.
See, if they are feeling threatened, that's enough for them to call 100.
Okay.
And then if they are being stalked, if they are being sexually harassed, then they have to narrate the incident as it happened. If any cognizable offense has happened, then their first information report will be registered with the police station and the appropriate action will be taken on their complaint. Even if it's a non-cognizable report or if nothing has happened, it was a false alarm, then also DD entry will be made or a non-cognizable report will be lodged and they will be given a copy so that later on if they want, they can take an action. But I mean, in some of the offenses where police does not take action because it is not laid out, we have come out with the various other helplines also to just to make life easier for women. It's like, you know, a stalking helpline. Now, stalking is not an offense till now. So, but a woman, if she is being stalked, she can dial 1096. She can note down the number of the vehicle which she is being talked. She can, you know, take down the description of a person who's doing it. So that, you know, that's again being smart of your surroundings and what's happening around you. And another thing is, if you're receiving obscene calls, which is now becoming a menace in the society.
That's true.
So again, 1096 is a number you can dial. You can leave the number from which you are receiving the calls and the police does respond. Even if you don't want any criminal action, we ensure that the calls stop. So these are the additional things which we are doing, the Delhi police is doing, just to make life easier for women, recognizing that it's a menace which is there.
True. So, Poonamji, finally, do you think that gender sensitization is something that has to be tackled a little more seriously, and maybe it has to be now made a part of the curricula, especially in at the school level itself? Do you think it's time for the government to think about that now?
Yeah, I think so. कि इट हैज टू बी मेड अ पार्ट ऑफ द स्टडीज राइट फ्रॉम द बिगनिंग द गर्ल्स शुड बी एजुकेटेड कि व्हाट आर देयर राइट्स एंड एग्जैक्टली हाउ शुड दे टैकल दैट सिचुएशन And even, you know, what you showed about the martial arts and all, I think, you know, rather than becoming a victim, prevention is always better than
cure. True, absolutely.
So they should train themselves, and even parents should play a very important role in this. And right from the beginning, and you know, one thing I've noticed, ke, the society is becoming very insensitive nowadays. Just today in the TV, I saw, okay, one lady was having labor pain in the train, but none of the people sitting, the passengers, helped her out. Or the husband and wife went in the toilet and the baby was delivered there in the latrine. So you can understand what life has become like, you know.
Absolutely, absolutely. I think it's time for us to actually to be very, very sensitive as far as the girl, child and the youngsters are concerned. Well, thank you very much for being a part of this show, and I do hope that the people will carry the right message home today. And friends, women, I think, have to take it upon themselves to help themselves. It may not always be right to play the lost babe in the woods number. You really need to remain alert and on your guard almost at all times. The society at large needs to take collective responsibility of our women folk and give them an environment that is conducive in all respects. Their safety has to be of paramount importance in the eyes of the authorities, the law, and also the citizens. A collective effort can go a long way in proving that safety net to our women folk wherever they may live or work. So on that note, it's time for me to wrap up today's show. I promise to see you next week with another information-packed discussion on another gender issue. Till then, this is Dr. Yararik saying goodbye, and take very good care of yourselves.